I believed I had no choice.
No choice?
Next time we die, or Kratos gets a headache.
Darkness come! Your turn!
Mimir, can you hear me? Has my voice broken through?
Sigrun? Yes! Hello! How are you talking to... How long have you been in...
Tell me, Kratos, truly, how did it feel to plunge your homeland into darkness?
I did not intend the land to suffer, but I was indifferent, consumed only by rage and retribution.
That is not what I asked.
A Minotaur. Now we'll see who's half a man.
Mimir, I had a thought. What you said to me, but you didn't think you could give me what I needed. I've been trying to.
Behind you! Watch out!
Race!
Oh, you've missed these slippery bastards, haven't you? Break the tether, quickly! I'll be waiting for you, Spartan. And if all your new friends knew how you used to treat your old friends.
Yes. And look, I think Kratos may have survived that time.
So it's Tyr's game you're playing? This is all his idea?
A game is not his purpose. There is something here I must see through.
And what is that exactly?
A process.
All right. If it's helping, I trust you both.
We all do. As we trust in Valhalla.
Even after what it did to you?
I knew the rules and chose to break them. I regret nothing.
Ah, the key again.
You are fighting your way deeper into Valhalla, General. Keep going.
Sigrun, I wanted to tell you. Valhalla keeps sweeping me away to my own adventure in memory.
I wondered if it would. That's wonderful. What is it showing you?
Some particular events of my wayward youth, but they're in a loop of sorts. Not sure I've quite gleaned what it all amounts to.
Then you must do what you do in Valhalla. Keep going.
Since we keep going back in, I take it this process is working for you somehow.
Yes. Succeed or fail, I feel progress, clarity. I need to see it.
An infamous act, one they still spoke of in the years of rebuilding. I somehow doubt they meant it so little.
I'll give you this, brother. Your technique has improved immeasurably.
I needed his power to secure my vengeance against the gods. I believed I had no choice.
Choice? You could have not ripped my head off my body. That was absolutely an option.
And he's back.
But that wasn't the worst, was it, Kratos? Killing me deprived Greece of the sun. They were plunged into perpetual cold and darkness. Crops ceased to grow. Famine descended on our homeland. Not that you care.
Enough.
He is better, isn't he?
Kratos, I'm curious. Your decision to behead Helios, was it fueled by any personal motivations? Was it really just a means to an end?
It was not personal. I did know him long before I killed him. He was as insufferable as any god. But his death gave me satisfaction.
Did you know what would happen as a result?
When Helios was captured by the god of dreams, the lands fell into darkness and were not restored until his return. I knew exactly what would happen.
Before you first found your way to me, you were grappling with the symbolism of your former seat of power. May I offer a perspective?
You may.
Before I became God of War, I felt as hesitant as you did. I feared that taking the throne would only validate Odin's power hierarchy, which even then I didn't trust. But I decided I could wield a better influence on the inside than on the outside. There are many ways to lead. Not all of them involve ruling. The throne and the office are only what you bring to them.
Dear, earlier you spoke to me as though I seek to lead. As if I was someone to be followed.
Your self-criticism, valid and otherwise, seem well reflected in your Valhalla. It's no accident that your mind manifested that throne. More than so. It's a challenge to revisit your assumptions. Mimir is right. You have the power, and I think the wisdom, to redefine what it means to you. To assert that power, prove to yourself that the chair doesn't change you, doesn't make you a new person. Not if you know who you are and why you serve.
Yeah!
memory of all things.
And lest we forget, Kratos, lest we neglect to place your deed in full and proper context, I saved your life. Me! And you literally tore off my head for my troubles. Imagine if all your new friends knew how you used to treat your old friends. Of course, you're not the same man, right? Now, you only get your friends killed through lack of foresight. Far easier to blame others that way. Am I right?
I know you are a projection of the mind. But for what it is worth, the death I gave you was unjust.
Oh, how touching. Yeah, not actually worth the spittle it took to mumble that out. Do not do that again. Nobody wants to hear that from you. A little something to remember me by. I truly hope it brings you unrelenting torment. Chills you just a little when they do that, doesn't it? Feels like judgment.
Slippery bastards, haven't you? Break the tether, quickly! Incoming dive!
You can prevail.
Sigrun, inside we encountered a son of Thor.
It wouldn't really be him in there, I can assure you.
You have a memory of a past fight, and I'm sure Valhalla takes advantage.
But why him?
I don't think that's for me to say.
A flute? Oh, will you play a song, brother?
It was my daughter's. But I will...
Mimir, can you hear me? Has my voice broken through?
Sigrun? Yes! Hello! How are you talking to... How long have you been able to hear?
I haven't been listening to you. There's just something I needed to tell you. Valhalla is displeased with me. It wishes a penance of sorts. Tries to reforge my loyalty. I haven't decided what to do, but... I hoped we could talk about it.
Aye. Let's do. Next time we die, or Kratos gets a headache.
The flute you found. You said it belonged to your daughter.
I bought it for her as a gift. She enjoyed playing and was skilled with it. There was a song she played. One I used to remember every note of.
Brother, if you mean to recount the story of the day you were tricked into killing your wife and daughter, you don't have to. You've told that story before. We know how it ends. You needn't relive it. That's not the story her flute brings to mind, is it?
No.
Incoming dive!
Charging at us.
thought everything was all right.
It is. For you are alive. And I am no longer in pain. But my transgression was not without consequences. Valhalla has penalized me. I could not enter now if I wanted to. In fact, I am not sure if it will welcome me in death.
What? That can't be right. No one's more worthy of Valhalla than you. You can't have sacrificed that for my sake. It's not fair.
There's no blame to place here. When you do what you know is right in your heart, the results are not always what you hope for. That doesn't mean it was the wrong decision. Now please, we've kept Kratos long enough from his journey. I insist. Go. We'll talk more.
Still got it.
Calliope's root again. Still on your mind, brother?
Yes. I will explain later.
The more that Valhalla makes me revisit my misadventures with Oberon, the more like a dream it all seems.
Which is ironic. Back then in my youth, I could hardly bear to sleep. Then, with time, I came to value a proper night's rest. In captivity, it was nearly the only escape I knew. And then the need to sleep went away completely. And I don't miss the time lost, but damn it, brother, I do miss dreaming.
The mind comes to terms with itself in ways only possible with your waking judgment out of the way. Our hidden desires, our anxieties, like a Bifrost window to what's going on in your soul.
And Valhalla does the same.
Aye. And I don't think I realized how much I needed it.
Linnea, I've been thinking a lot about the costs and risks of what Valhalla will put me through to affirm my loyalty. It's enough to make me question not my love of this place, but is it really what's most important to me? If I can't answer that, perhaps I am not ready for such a decision.
Then you should take all the time you need. Absolutely. If Valhalla isn't what you truly need, then you have a rare opportunity to reassess your priorities.
I'm glad you agree.
The day my family died was not the last time I saw Calliope. I had journeyed to the underworld to rescue Helios. When I arrived, song on the wind and found her in the fields of Elysium. It had been long since I felt such joy, but it was another trick of the gods.
It wasn't her.
Worse. It was. The goddess of the underworld wished to destroy all of creation, Elysium included. She knew that for me to stand against her meant leaving Calliope behind forever. So, I pushed my daughter away again. all while she cried and begged me not to. Calliope's flute.
Whenever you're ready, brother, take your time.
Nalir, I had a thought. What you said to me, but you didn't think you could give me what I needed. I've been trying to figure out why you say such things. I know you don't say things without a reason, even if you don't know what it is at first. But I think I figured it out. It's not that there is anything lacking in you. It's that in the end, nobody can give me everything I need to be happy. Not even Valhalla. That's something I have to give myself. And to do that,
you need to find yourself. True. And we're saying that's what I meant all along. Clever, right?
I'm sure you can see by now. Valhalla has a way of making you learn what you need. Perhaps it does so with me. Even now. Making such demands so as to give me doubts. Long ago, I gave myself completely to love. And it destroyed my home and family. Then I threw myself into the service of Valhalla and found a new family in my sisters. But what if that's not where my story ends? It's time I finally found my path. Not because it may or may not be Valhalla's will, or Freya's, or yours, my dear.
Well said, love. Father, the choice you were given, to stay in Elysium with your daughter only to perish? Seems like no choice at all.
Of course it was a choice. One I wished many times I'd made differently.
How so?
When I left Greece, Calliope was never far from my mind. I do not know how much time we would have had together in Elysium. But I would have traded the decades that followed for mere hours with her. It took meeting Faye for that feeling to go away, along with Calliope's song. But I do still think of her in Elysium, and hope she found peace.
Find your brother!
Strike it! Now! Incoming left side! I suppose Valhalla's impressed with that kill.
How interesting. A dragon bird.
I hope it pecks you to death. Parry its attack!
Don't you wish you could have broken the mast and skewered all their heads with it?
a factor here.
Again, still not used to that.
The good Spartan returns. I have another cherished weapon from my travels to show you. Ready to see?
Be ready.
Different, consumed only by rage and retribution.
That is not what I asked. How did it feel in that moment, your soul given over to darkness, bringing a darkness over everything you could see?
It felt true.
Darkness come! Your turn!
That light over there, brother!
Be ready. Having fun yet?
I yield.
Good then.
I don't think you were indifferent, Kratos. I think you were hurt. Deeply hurt. And you handled it unskillfully.
Wait, is that you restoring the sun? You took Helios' chariot and put the sun back in the sky, but sacrificed yourself in the process.
Yes. I fell to my death, and was saved by Helios. But this memory happened before I killed him. My evils were yet to come. What is the point?
That your legacy has always been a complicated one. That goodness is not a destination we arrive at, but a practice. Misfortune may drive anyone to darkness. We resist it only through wisdom and vigilance. You are not so unskillful now as you were then. Better voices in your head, you might call it. I think that's enough for now. You have much to contemplate.
Yes.
Back to the beach then.
You should be proud of your progress, Kratos. See you soon.
seems like you're making progress, whatever you're doing in there.
Perhaps.
Listen, I know I made you feel like we expected more of you than you could give. And I just want you to know, I'm not asking you to change how you are or who you are. We had to break the old world to build a new one. Picking up the pieces and putting them together stronger, it's a rare opportunity. You made a difference here. In some circles, a symbol of change. On many days, just knowing that you're a part of the Council is enough.
And other days?
You've earned a voice. How you use it is up to you.